Understand it's with a very unusual individual. To Cal Rudman we go with his most interesting and unique interview.
Cal Rudman in the backstage area. We are here with Brutus Beefcake and his manager, Luscious Johnny. Well, your boy's doing pretty well. He hasn't been hurt at all yet. He's been doing all the hurting.
No, he's doing all the hurting. He's doing all the poking and jiving and ripping and roaring and up and down and wham, bam, thank you, ma'am. And he's certainly making a name for himself. I'm down at Turnpike across the United States. All the Greyhound bus stations are talking about him. All the people in the cocktail lounges are talking about him. Lawyers, doctors, psychiatrists, people in the influential areas of this United States, people in Saudi Arabia. I saw a sheik the other day at the airport, and he was going, how are you? Yeah, here we're all talking about him. You know, they're with their Mercedes Benzes, the Honda. Everybody's talking. Everybody's talking about Brutus Beefcake. And a simple fact remains, ladies and gentlemen, nobody talks about Luscious Johnny. You know why? Because I am the type of guy that, you know why? They take it for granted that I'm soft. You know what I mean? They know, in other words, they know that Johnny Valiant, this is just my par situation. In other words, I'm just exploiting myself as every time I go into the ring, I am letting each and every one know that I trim my mustache, I bleach my hair. You don't understand. This is just me. You look in the back of my jacket, what's it say? It doesn't say Post Nobels. It says the Luscious One. You know, that's people know that's Luscious Johnny Valiant. Now, my main claim to fame is to introduce this young athlete right here, young Brutus Beefcake. And no, he's not the boy next door. No, he's not the son of an insurance agent living in Delaware. He is the man that is from coast to coast like Bordenhouse toast. He is the man that has landed in the World Wrestling Federation and has exploited himself as a professional wrestler, as a gifted athlete, as what's happening in the 80s. We're flipping the calendar, into 1985, and there he's going to launch.
I just want to tell you, ladies out there, Brutus Beefcake is single, but to get to Brutus Beefcake, you got to go first through Luscious Johnny Valentine. Now back to ringside.
Johnny Valiant, is that my name?
Right.
Felix Unger and Oscar Mattersson, no doubt, the odd couple. Brutus Beefcake, very loquacious in that interview, as you saw. Seemed that Johnny Valiant didn't want to give him a word edgewise. But wrestling ability is what counts, and Brutus Beefcake certainly has a lot of that. And the managerial strategies of Johnny Valiant have been brought out thus far. Valiant very proud to make Brutus Beefcake his very first man in the World Wrestling Federation. And as time comes by, you never know if Brutus Beefcake is going to ascend to the top. Speaking of managers, speaking of talent, Cal Rudman has a big man in every stretch of the word, along with a brain for a manager. Cal, let's take it to you.
Cal Rudman in the backstage area. I got to say, I got to give this to you. Until you took over, Bobby the Brain, this man's career was not as exciting as it is now.
That's a bunch of baloney. My career has gone a long ways. We got together because we help each other. That's a stupid statement to make. Bobby Heenan and I got together because we took something good and we're making it greater.
The reason him and I are together, this man was an established star in professional wrestling for years. But now he was so busy, so much traveled all over the world, so much in demand, he needed a business agent. He needed someone to make sure his interest was looked out for. And that's exactly what I'm doing. I'm not interfering in any matches. I'm not helping him win. I don't have to help a man 7 foot tall win 400 pounds. His size, his strength, his record speaks for itself. This is the giant of professional wrestling, the only true giant in professional wrestling, John Studd.
All right, you brought up the word giant, and we all heard what the fans were saying tonight. I mean, the whole
really
story about Andre.
Let's talk about our match coming up in a few short minutes.
Well, we're not getting any place, so we're going to have to just go back to ringside. Have it your way,
Hogan,
guys. That's it. Back to ringside.
Well, Cal Rudman having his problems in the locker room with the big guy, but stay with us, wrestling fans. Gorilla Monsoon along with Howard Finkel, and great matches upcoming in a moment. Coming up, the big one, J.Y.D., the Junkyard Dog. Can't wait, Howie.
He is electricity personified, Gorilla. And as I mentioned earlier, let's just find out in a little bit how wonderful Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff really is.
Well, I give a lot of credit to anyone who has the athletic background and the credentials that a Mr. Wonderful possesses when he steps through these ring ropes. This guy is a fantastic athlete. And, you know, as much as I dislike some of the mannerisms he uses, some of the cliches he uses, and some of the tactics he uses in the ring, I have to respect his ability.
There is no doubt that the man is a gifted athlete. former professional football player, has kept himself in remarkable condition, but for that matter, Gorilla, the Junkyard Dog is no slouch as well. And the only thing that the Junkyard Dog might have over Paul Orndorff tonight in this evenly matched contest, in my view, is the fan support.
Well, I think that Paul Orndorff is destined to wear gold around his waist. That's how strongly I feel on the individual. It's just a question of time, where it's going to take place, when it's going to take place. I have no way of knowing that, but I'm in my own mind, I know that this man is championship material, as well as is JYD, who
well,
can
certainly
beat anyone on any given night. Look at the brain. Here comes the brain.
Boy, talk about quick change, artists.
Well, there he is in all his glory, and there's Mr. Wonderful, and look at that beautiful ring robe. You're looking at a $5,000 number there, ladies and gentlemen. And with that, let's go up to our ring announcer.
Wrestling fans, the following contest is set for one fall with a 45-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. Ladies and gentlemen, from Tampa, Florida, weighing 252 pounds, Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff.
Let's get one thing straight. The name is Paul, P-A-U-L, and let's get it straight.
Look at the signs everywhere saying Paula.
And this
capacity crowd is on its feet.
The dust. And here he comes, Gorilla.
Look at the change and look at the look of confidence on that face.
180 pounds, the Junkyard Dog.
Crank up the music. The dog has arrived.
They're going to do his stuff.
Juking, that's what he calls it. I don't think Orndorff wants to dance.
No way, bailing it out.
Look at the dog groove.
Shoot a juke.
Whoa.
One swipe of that 15-foot chain and it's all over. And the fans are on their feet as they loving it. Orndorff's not getting a big thrill out of this, but
where did Bobby Heenan go?
He took a powder. He's a great sign. He's wandering around here. He won't be far from the action.
I think maybe he and Mr. Wonderful aren't quite ready for battle yet.
Well, they're going to think about this for a moment, try to break the momentum of what's going on here. Well, Mr. Wonderful checking.
Inciting the wrath of Gorilla Monsoon, Bobby Heenan. It's awful easy, Gorilla. It's awful easy to lose your temper.
Well, I don't like anybody touching my associates, Howard.
Well, I appreciate that.
I don't let anybody lay hands on my friends here at the table. Mr. Wonderful's got his work cut out for him with JYD. He's over here messing with us. The chant, Paula goes out.
That is something that is sore music to Mr. Orndorff's ears. Bobby Heenan earlier said the name is P-A-U-L. After he said, oh, I heard a resounding A.
Oh, look at the dog, Howie.
Well, the dog is ready.
Questioning the masculinity of Mr. Wonderful. Boy, is he ready. He is in shape. He hasn't taken his eyes off of Paul for one moment. Or from the brain either. Boy,
look at the dog.
It's a double, you know, you're in double jeopardy here.
Well, it's 2-on-1. Look at. There they go again. This is the Junkyard Dog's second ally, the fans.
Absolutely.
Although sometimes, Gorilla, it works in reverse. If the Paula chant continues, that could certainly set off a fuse in Mr. Orndorff.
Well, it will set up a fuse, but it will be a distraughtful one and one of anger. And you usually lose your cool at that point. Better get the robe off here and get this thing going.
I do not want to continually praise Bobby Heenan, but for the most part in the WWF, Paul Orndorff was without a manager. I don't know how Bobby Heenan did it. I don't know what Paul Orndorff said, but the marriage has been made. Bobby Heenan, Paul Orndorff, there forever.
Obviously.
Orndorff doesn't care about anything. Orndorff thinks he's the greatest thing since sliced bread.
Obviously. Look at the dog. Hasn't taken his eyes off either one of these individuals for one
Look
second.
Out.
He wants the brain out of there, and rightly so. The brain has to go. Cannot remain inside those ring ropes. Whether he'll be allowed to remain at ringside remains to be seen.
Oh, Bobby Heenan's not the referee. He shouldn't be checking Orndorff out.
Absolutely not.
Dick Worley's finally had it. No nonsense.
He's gone.
And if Heenan doesn't watch himself, he's going to be ejected from the ringside area.
He's going to be allowed to stay, obviously, at ringside.
Well, he does have a managerial permit.
But you have to get special permission to remain at ringside, and obviously he's done that.
Yes, sir.
Well, if I were J.Y. and I knew that, I would have made some other arrangements as well.
Well, J.Y.D., I have a little confidence of. J.Y.D., I think, is going to have eyes in the back of his head for this match.
Well, he literally will have to.
Look at the dog, Gorilla. Paula.
Going to get underway here, and the sparks are going to fly, ladies and gentlemen.
Wait till contact is made. Look at the back of Orndorff's trunks. Mr. Wonderful with a number one. Is he modest or what?
He doesn't have to have anyone love him because he loves himself so much.
Heenan said timeout, Paul. Here's some more strategy. Bobby the Brain Heenan.
I'm sure they've got a tremendous game plan involved for this particular matchup, and as it unfolds, it should be most interesting.
Well, personally speaking, this match is pivotal for either man. Whoever can get the victory will possibly move up that much more in the ladder of contention.
Well, both of these individuals are in the top 10 in the entire world of professional wrestling, and anyone of them could be given a shot by the World Wrestling Federation at the Hulkster's title at any time. But certainly a win would enhance that considerably.
Do you think Paul Orndorff is stalling somewhat, Gorilla?
Obviously. It's obvious tactic. Heenan is trying to get the dog to get Ben out of shape.
Well, the dog is ready, and all of a sudden, just as contact is about to be made, Heenan intervenes. He says, come here, Paul. Let's talk some more. Probably about nothing.
Obviously.
I think the Junkyard Dog's patience is wearing thin.
Yes, it is. There's the lockup.
All right.
Dog pushes back Mr. Wonderful.
He might have realized that the dog is strong.
Oh, he's a powerhouse. He doesn't have that definition that Paula, Orndorff trying to throw off the dog, but the dog had too big a cinch up on that side headlock, and once again drags him across the ring. He's trying to throw him off, but no way. As the dog showing us the tenacity by holding on to that side headlock. Now he slips underneath, looking to power out to a standing wrist lock of his own. Test the strength here, as neither man has a decided advantage at this point. If the dog goes down to that left knee, Paul will have the power advantage, but no, dog's coming up now. Listen to the crowd come up as well. Dog takes him back down around and into that side headlock once more.
Tremendous strength. Bobby Heenan not happy about the turn of events. He's claiming that the dog pulled Orndorff's hair. fat chance, Mr. Heenan.
The referee, Dick Worley, keeping a close eye on the brain. He's there right goes the dog off. Down in front, but look how quick he came around. Oh. Shoulder block, one of his favorite moves. Back into the side headlock. Boy, the dog's got that shoulder block patted down. Boy, he catches you in that corner with it. It's goodbye. Curtain time.
Devastating.
Cinching up now. He's got that wrist cocked, which gives him that little extra. Look at Arndorf now, stepping over the top rope, doing anything to break the hold. Dog's not going to break this, as far as I can see. Oh, Arndorf's out now. He's got to break it. Got to break it or bring him back in, one of the two. Oh, he's going to bring him back in. Dragged him right back over the top rope.
It's kind of stuck.
Referee's counting him. He's going to have to break it. Wow.
Boy, Heenan is upset.
Arndorf came down hard as his toes were tacked onto that top rope. And now a little consultation as well as a little soothing of the nerves.
Oh, give me a break, Gorilla. Meanwhile, Dick Worley's counting, and if Paul Arndorf doesn't watch himself, he might be counted out.
I'm sure the dog doesn't want to win that way. He wants to prove to the wrestling world that he is the superior man, and he wants to do it right inside those ring ropes. Arndorf's strategy not working at this point. Tied up once more, backed into the ropes is the dog. Referee calling for the break here. Ah, what a knee. Oh, big right hand by Arndorf. Starting to unload the heavy artillery now on the dog. Look at the look.
Five in a row,
that was right in the throat. Heenan happy. Likes what he's seeing now. Wasn't too happy a moment ago. Look at Arndorf. Is he happy with himself?
It's hard to be humble for him.
When you're great, it's hard.
Yes, sir.
That's the wrong thing to do.
If he thinks that the Junkyard Dog is feeling any iota of that turnbuckle pad, he is going to be sadly mistaken.
There's the block, and the table's turned, and Arndorf just went cross-eyed on that one. He doesn't know where he is right now. Go get him, Dog. Full force behind that one as he drove him into that top turnbuckle. Snap mare takes him over. He wants him up now. He's going to give that dog butt. Here it comes. Wow. And another one. He drove him right outside the ring.
Arndorf says timeout. Bobby Heenan once again protesting vehemently. I guess he's claiming it's an illegal move.
Absolutely nothing illegal about that.
No.
Complain all you like.
Arndorf does look like he has realized finally that he is in a battle. Cocky, confident.
Battle of his career, possibly, here.
Yes, sir. Cocky and confident at the outset. Perhaps worried now and frustrated.
When you're an outstanding athlete, you can rely on a lot of things. And I'm sure Arndorf has got a bushel of them. And the dog is thinking constantly, you know. That's the key to success. Oh, look at the strength move by Arndorf. Side suplexed him from a side headlock, and that's 270 pounds or so going over with that, and there's no way you have any momentum going for you there. Foreign object just thrown into the ring by a fan, which is a big mistake because Arndorf picked it up and used it. Folks, you just don't do that. Being admonished now by referee Dick Worley, but Paul is saying, give me a break.
I didn't do a thing.
Knee right to the back of the neck of the dog. Sends him down to the canvas and he's hurt. Wow, right on the chin.
The dog could be right for the picking right now, Gorilla.
Instructions being shouted from outside by Bobby the Brain. Look at this, elbow right to the throat. Dog's in a lot of trouble. Won't get him that way. Nonchalant cover there by Mr. Wonderful.
Not hook the leg.
Can't beat a guy with a caliber of talent or a dog with that kind of a maneuver. Reverse chin lock now with the knee being forced into the back of the neck of the dog. And this will take its toll. Look at how those fingers are interlaced. For that additional power. And the chant goes up and the crowd comes to life here in this jam-packed Meadowlands Arena. As this is what it's all about in pro wrestling, the World Wrestling Federation brings you the best. And the fans just love it. Whirly right on top of the situation, asking the dog if he wants to submit. Highly unlikely.
I would seriously doubt it. Junkyard Dog has more resiliency than we'll ever know.
Absolutely. Got to come around, dog. You got to turn in or turn out or sit out and get to your feet. Because this Orndorff will do a number on you if you give him a chance. Takes him down to the canvas now. That's a choke. Got that thumb right in the throat, Dick. He sees it now. But too much time gone by there. Too much damage done.
And Orndorff takes advantage of the count right to the very last second.
Dog coming up now. Got to his knees. Trying to make a power maneuver here. As Orndorff locked into the traps on the left side of the dog, but the dog's on his feet. Big plus for him. Show me some power, dog. Power out of this thing. Look at this. Look at the power being displayed here by the dog. Picks that left arm of Orndorff right on both of them and a headbutt to the stomach. But the dog's hurt. Nice knee lift by Orndorff.
Orndorff still has a lot left in him. As the dog. Bobby Heenan seems to be quite happy.
Very pleased. Once again, nonchalant cover. Oh, now he's going to tell the referee how to do his job.
Well, Bobby Heenan was voted manager of the year on four separate occasions.
Well, tonight won't be one of them.
No, I don't think so.
Off the second turnbuckle, down onto the back of the neck of the dog, and once again, he's in trouble. You won't get him that way, Paul. Sorry. Complaining to the referee. You didn't do the proper maneuver, my friend, to get the victory. You're the one at fault, not the referee. Dog in serious trouble. Orndorff, very methodical. Oh, thumb right to the throat, blinded out by the body of the dog. Referee to the blind side. Another elbow right on the throat. No way, forget it.
He is not following
through.
Can't
believe he's doing that.
And Heenan assailing the virtues of the referee in reverse. Can't you count? I think the referee is quite confident in his count.
Back again on the second turnbuckle from the inside. He got caught with a right hand as he was coming down. Full momentum right on the jaw. Maybe the throat. Oh, it was in the throat, obviously. He can't seem to get any breath. Can't seem to get any oxygen, but he's still coming. No. The dog with the right hand caught him once more. The dog coming to life, a left. Orndorff right there now once more, exchanging blows, snap there by the dog, look out.
Oh,
he wasn't there. Desperation move on the part of Orndorff as he was snapped over. Dog set him up what I thought was very nicely, but Orndorff with that resiliency, right back on top of the situation.
This could be it.
No way. No way. No way. I'm sorry, Paul. You're not going to beat this guy like that. He's getting disgusted, Orndorff is.
The more disgusted he's getting, the more aggressive he's getting, Gorilla.
Well, he's getting aggressive, but he's using the wrong maneuver. He's putting the boots to the head of the dog. That's not going to hurt him. Pile driver maybe coming up. He's got him up there. Yes, he gave it to him.
Finishing maneuver.
Well, it works on a lot of guys. Whether it work on the dog, I don't know. The dog just rolled right out.
Well, that will save him from being pinned for the time being.
Hard out onto the arena ice. Orndorff very pleased with himself. The dog obviously hurt, but even though the dog has a very hard head, Howard, as everyone is well aware of, the damage to the neck is what counts on that pile driver.
Absolutely.
We'll have to see how much of a toll that took. Orndorff not waiting. He wants to go out after him. Whirly saying no. Stay in the ring. That's the right maneuver right there.
Dick Whirly is right on the ball.
Dog has not gotten up yet. Well, Orndorff went out the opposite side now, so he doesn't have to contend with the referee. Sort of nonchalantly going around there. The dog is still down from Arvin. There he is. Orndorff picks him up bodily. What's he going to do? Slam him? Oh, no. Slams him down hard onto the ice-covered floor here at the Meadowlands Arena. Orndorff probably will get back into the ring and let the referee count out the very seriously injured dog at this point.
Well, if Orndorff wants to get a win, that's a smart thing to do. Just stay in the ring, and it should be easy for the 10 or 20 count, whatever it may be.
Well, he just shook hands with the brain, figuring that this match is over. Look at the doggedness.
Look at the determination on the dog.
Wow, he's coming back. He's
never say die.
He's got to get back inside that ring. Orndorff, all the way across with a big boot, once again sends him down to the arena floor.
And as you mentioned, on that homosote covering the ice, that is not a soft fall.
It's just like being outside on a parking lot.
Exactly.
Orndorff thrilled with himself.
So is Bobby Heenan.
Let's get a shot. Look at the posing here. Let's get a shot, if we can, of the dog. See what kind of shape he's in. There he is. He's still coming back. You got to love this guy. Orndorff right back over on top of the situation. Dick Worley got to keep him back there. Give this guy a chance to get back into the ring. Trying to come back is the dog, but Orndorff right on top of the situation, not giving him that chance. Grabs him by the ears. Going to try to slam him back in. Yes, he does. And the dog takes him right over. He got him. What an unbelievable three count. I can't believe it.
That is a tremendous, tremendous surprise.
The dog small packaged him from that slam. What a maneuver.
To think that the whole match was Paul Orndorff. The split second coming over the three count.
Fans on their feet, and look at Orndorff. He's in great shape. Not even hurt. The dog is down inside the ring in extremely bad shape, but had the foresight and the momentum to slap on that small package. Let's go back in time just a moment. Oh, wait a minute. Let's go back. Let's stay with the live action. Orndorff attacking. He's not finished by a long shot, boys. He's been out of shape, but the dog is still hurt.
Upset, frustrated, Paul Orndorff taking it all out on the dog, and he is not done yet.
Down goes the dog, and right out after him goes Mr. Wonderful. Stay with this. This is not over by a long shot. Look out, not the post. He rammed face first the Junkyard Dog right into the steel post. It was not head first, Howard. It was face first.
Boy, the Junkyard Dog.
If that didn't bust him wide open, I would be very surprised, because that ring steel post does not move, ladies and gentlemen. It is solid.
And Heenan and Orndorff think that they've won, that they've got their revenge.
The brain raising a hand, but he's not done yet. Let's stay with this.
Oh, look at this. He decked Dick Worley.
Dick Worley got in the way and was given a shot.
And yes, the Junkyard Dog has been busted open by Paul Orndorff. You are right.
Look at that. Orndorff throws him back into the ring now with a steel chair. Give me a break.
This is far from over. Look at the Junkyard Dog.
Orndorff going back into the ring with a steel chair. Referee Dick Worley.
Oh,
did
no.
Did you hear that?
Good night.
Did you hear that?
Thump.
Junkyard Dog could be in serious, serious trouble here, as he was just decked by that steel chair. Orndorff still on top of him. Dick Worley trying to get him out of there. We may need some assistance, not only to get the dog out, but to get Mr. Wonderful out.
Paul Orndorff is definitely setting himself up for a suspension, a fine, you name it.
He's already been fined. I've got news for him. But I'm concerned right now with the Junkyard Dog, who is still...
He is motionless.
Face down in the center of the ring. Doesn't seem to be a whole lot of movement.
The dog is motionless. I don't think the Junkyard Dog knows where he is right now.
He's trying to regain something. He's trying to get to his knees here at least. Dick Worley right on top of him. The doctor, we got to get the doctor in there. Take a look at this guy. Worley motioning for some help from the dressing room area. Doctor trying to roll the dog over. Fat chance if he doesn't want to go, Doc.
Oh, the dog doesn't want it.
Doesn't want to see the doctor. Wow, I can see globs of
here
blood.
Comes some assistants into the ring. We have got Jose Luis Rivera, George Wells, Jim Powers. They're all coming in to aid their fallen comrade.
What a dastardly maneuver. Unsportsmanlike by Mr. Wonderful, and believe me, that name does not suit him whatsoever, as he just plummeled, literally, the dog into this bloody condition that he's in right now, rammed him into that steel post, and then that wasn't enough. Had to take a steel chair from ringside and literally ran across the ring with it, Howard, and jammed him right in the face.
If the Junkyard Dog knows full well, Gorilla, memories are not going to be short in any stretch of the imagination. Junkyard Dog will have his day.
Well, right now you got to be concerned. The guy could have a very serious concussion here. Doctor trying to get a look at it. Trying to size up the injury. See how seriously the cut is. May have a broken nose. We can't tell from our vantage point, not by a long shot. The dog doesn't really know, I'm sure, where he's even at right now.
No, this capacity crowd here at the arena is...
They're on their feet.
On their feet, but
concerned. Yet... Concerned.
Quiet.
Very, very quiet. Dog, very delirious at this point, doesn't know where he is.
Right now, Gorilla, the victory is second nature to what's happening in the ring.
Oh, absolutely. Absolutely. I'm not even sure that the dog knows that he won. No, really, because it was an instinctive move that he did. In fact, if we can go back in time and take a look at that, as the dog is literally being carried from the ring as the blood just profusely running down his face. His friends in there helping him back to the dressing room. Let's go back in time and take a look at what transpired here. Orndorff from the inside scoop slams the dog over the top rope. Well, look at here as the dog reaches underneath with that small package maneuver. I'm sure it was instinctive. He really wasn't sure what he was doing. He had already been taking a tremendous beating, but he did get the three count. Dog, not quite able to make it back to the dressing room, went down a couple of times. Wrestling fans, stay with us. We'll be back with more wrestling in just a moment. Gorilla Monsoon at ringside here with my good friend and associate Howard Finkel, and we're awaiting the appearance of the Rowdy One as the ring is set in that beautiful plaid carpeting, Hal, with those two chairs up there. It's going to be interesting to see what's going to transpire here as we go to a live Piper's Pit.
Well, I'm looking forward to it, Gorilla. Everyone who views the World Wrestling Federation Network knows of Rowdy Roddy Piper, knows of Piper's Pit, and the controversy that it invokes. Now here at the Meadowlands Arena, a live Piper's Pit. Who knows?
This pit may never take place, Howard, because scheduled to be in this pit is the JYD, is the Junkyard Dog.
As we just saw, the Junkyard Dog probably doesn't even know where he is, what time it is, what day it is. It will be interesting to see if the dog even comes out for an appearance in Piper's Pit Live.
He might be in the process of being sutured up because he was bleeding profusely when he left here after that onslaught.
May we remind you about one thing with Rowdy Roddy Piper now. Wherever he goes, whatever he does, he has a sidekick, a bodyguard.
The ace.
The ace, a.k.a. Cowboy Bob Orton.
Waiting in the ring, in the wings, is this tremendous...
Here he comes.
Oh, there he comes in all his glory.
Not
Rowdy Roddy One.
Getting a very nice hand from the fans in reverse. I don't think there's too much love for Roddy Piper. And of course, Cowboy Bob Orton, his trusty sidekick, otherwise known as Ace, by his side at all times. Rowdy Roddy Piper, wherever he goes, Gorilla, and whatever he does, you can say that the middle name of Rowdy Roddy is controversy.
Absolutely. Piper's Pit coming up. Right here as the World Wrestling Federation continues.
Well, I think
to excite the wrestling world.
I think we're going to have to take a back seat right now to Rowdy Roddy and let him take the podium.
Absolutely.
You can do a lot better than that, man. The reason that I'm standing here doing a live pit is because last time I was here, I fought Andre the Giant, and after people saw that, nobody wanted to fight me no more. Oh, wait a second. You sit here living in New Jersey, and you're booing me. I wasn't wild about coming down here, man. I mean, let's face facts. Let's think about New Jersey for a second. All people in New Jersey, they go and they support the Giants, which is a football team from New York. Then,
this is what kills it.
Then, just because you're so nice and you support New York, they come back here and put all their garbage in Sea Caucus.
Around here to me,
man. Oh, no. You're talking to a man. A tiny piece of bread with no meat in it ain't gonna get it done for me. You see, I am the woman maker. That's probably something you have no idea. Although there is a lot of you in New Jersey. I try to find something interesting about New Jersey, and I talked to a senator, Steve Attaboot, who's a nice guy, and I said to myself, I'm going to go and I'm going to take a look at New Jersey, and I went down and I took a look at the train station in Newark. It was about 3:30 in the morning. You got to be mighty, mighty proud, man. Because I saw all these people laying down there, and they're all drunk, and the first thing I did when I got off the train is I kicked them right square. Policeman came up to me and he said, these people have a right to be here. This is a free country. Maybe for you it's free.
That ain't nothing. If your baseball teams could do that, well, maybe you should be playing for them. But that's why you folks are there sitting and listening to me. Because you really can't do nothing but sit and listen. But just in case there's somebody out there who can, I have asked to speak to one lady and one man. They told me to find a good-looking woman in New Jersey. Very easy, but anyway, I wanted to talk to two people from New Jersey first while the junkyard dog's pottering his nose. So whoever you have received from me, I'd like. I don't come from New Jersey. Have a seat. This here, incidentally, this here is my bodyguard. His name is Ace. Your name is what?
Jack Baker.
And where are you from?
Marstown, New Jersey.
Where were you born?
Marstown, New Jersey.
Why on earth would you stay in a place? Have you ever drove from Woodbridge, New Jersey to Newark Airport and smelt that factory halfway between? You don't have to grab it, I hold it.
I've driven there, I've never drove there.
I've driven there, I've never drove there. That's the difference between you and me, you see. I just hire people to spell for me. Give you a one-way ticket. I'm serious right now. As soon as you leave this ring, I'll set it up, give you cash. One-way ticket, Hawaii, Beirut, any place you want to go. I don't care where it is. You can have a one-way ticket. You can go and stay. Would you take it?
No.
Of New Jersey. For the ignorant people that are throwing things from New Jersey, if you do not have enough respect for yourself, please have enough respect for the lady.
What's your name?
Rosemary Mira.
Rosemary, are you from New Jersey?
No, unfortunately, I'm from Westchester.
You see that proof, my point? I said, I'm trying to find a pretty lady from New Jersey, and I couldn't do it here. I have a pretty lady, and where does she say she's from? Westchester. Prove my point. Tell me something. You can touch me if you want. My bodyguard is here, including myself. Who out of everybody, including myself, you can count me in, is your favorite wrestler of all time?
Hulk Hogan.
Is the Junkyard Dog from New Jersey, for chance? He looks like he's from New Jersey. I've seen the projects. If they will, and the Junkyard Dog has enough guts to, I would like the Junkyard Dog to come on down here and show all the intelligence he's had from New Jersey.
We're awaiting the dog. Where is he? Let's take a look at him.
That doesn't look like the Junkyard Dog to me.
Sorry, Paloma. Where's he going?
I don't understand this.
Salvatore obviously has something to say here.
What the hell are you doing here? I'm looking for the Junkyard Dog. I wasn't looking for a pizza. I was looking for the Junkyard Dog, man. What are you doing? No. What are you doing?
Junkyard Dog is hurt, and he can't make the spit, and I'm making for him.
The Junkyard Dog is hurt, and he cannot make it. Are you his messenger?
He's my friend, and he's hurt, and I come tell you what happened.
And have a, this is my bodyguard, Ace. You don't have to worry about it. Ace only attacks if I tell him to. You go ahead and have a seat. Don't worry about it. I know you, Sal. I know you. Have a seat. You can trust me, man. I'll sit down first. What is wrong with the Junkyard Dog?
Junkyard Dog get hurt, and he said to me,
wait a second, you dumb wop, I know he's hurt. That's the first thing, man. I know he's hurt.
Don't call me dumb wop, because you're gonna get you.
Oh, you're gonna beat me up? My bodyguard.
You need two people to get that kind of whop.
You think I need two people for you? Just wonderfulness, wonderfulness. How are you? Just relax. This guy here is telling me I'm supposed to interview the Junkyard Dog. Let me show you something. Just so they don't get cluttered. I'm supposed to interview the Junkyard Dog, but all of a sudden, he got no guts no more. This guy here is telling me that the Junkyard Dog can't come down here because he's hurt.
I really feel sorry for the Junkyard Dog. You know something, Roddy? How you doing, Ace? You know, here we are talking about a junkyard dog. Well, he don't look too bad to me, does he, to you?
I saw your match.
Well, thank you. You know something, we got a man, Junkyard Dog, who tells everybody that he's born and raised in the ghetto. And he gets a little bitty scratch on his forehead. And what does he do, like any normal dog would do? What did he do? He tucked his tail between his legs and he ran like a no good, dirty, greasy, yellow dog.
I think we should have a point here, though. But he said Salvatore here, good old Sal, as the messenger, huh? All of a sudden you want to be the man. Wait, whoa. Okay, wait a second. Wait, stop. Come here. Stop. Okay, I'll tell you what we'll do. No hard feelings, no nothing. About 2 months.
Look out, Salvatore. Salvatore, best bail out of there. He's in a lot of trouble.
Hey, Sal.
Look out, the dog is coming. The dog is coming with the chain. Look out, he tries with a clean house. Piper's gone over the top rope. Orndorff's still in there. Junkyard Dog wrapped up and still bleeding. Came out here and clean house. Holy mackerel, he came out of nowhere. Everybody heading for higher ground as the dog is on the warpath.
Boy, when Salvatore Palomo needed help.
Junkyard Dog obviously in the dressing room being stitched up, not able to make this pit when he found out his friend was in trouble. Here he come 100 miles an hour. You can still see the blood oozing through the bandages as the Junkyard Dog clears out the ring of Orton and Mr. Wonderful and Ace. Piper's pit is a shambles. Chairs in the ring, the bell is in the ring, and there goes the dog. Doesn't have to take a back seat to anybody.
No, Howard. Sir, Gorilla.
That's class personified. Unbelievable. Howard Finkel at ringside with yours truly, Gorilla Monsoon, here at the Meadowlands Arena. Jam-packed capacity crowd on hand. And they have witnessed a happening, as can only be brought to you by the World Wrestling Federation, the king of all professional wrestling.
Without a question, it's the mecca of professional wrestling.
All the action coming from the World Wrestling Federation and coming to you direct from the beautiful Meadowlands Arena, where they're hanging off the rafters, as is commonplace when the World Wrestling Federation comes into town. And still more great bouts yet to come.
We sure do have a great lineup still awaiting us. The presence of Brutus Beefcake, Mr. Beefcake, managed by luscious Johnny Valiant, to square off one-on-one with Salvatore Palomo. From there, it's Cowboy Bob Orton meeting the one and only Phenom, Superfly Jimmy Snuka. And speaking of Mr. Orton, here he is right now.
Ace is finding his way into the ring. Let's go up to our ring announcer.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is set for one fall with a 45-minute time limit. Introducing in the ring from Kansas City, Missouri, weighing 248 pounds, Cowboy Bob Orton. And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent entering the ring from the Fiji Islands, weighing 250 pounds, Jimmy Superfly Snuka.
The Phenom, the Superfly, and man, does he look great.
This is going to be a tremendous confrontation. We don't have to go over Jimmy Snuka's credibilities and attributes. He is a legend in his own time. Cowboy Bob Orton, many people rule him, Gorilla, as a consummate wrestler.
Pearl Harbor job by Orton. dastardly attack as Jimmy was still taking off his ring attire, and Orton attacks him from the back. A whip, no reversal. Upside down goes Orton in the corner, and he's stunned. And Jimmy right on the attack. Lowering lefts and rights, snapmare takes Orton over. Look out, headbutt. No, elbow right to the forehead. And Orton's paying now for that sneak attack. Jimmy is ready, and boy, is he unloading. Big chop in the corner.
Cowboy Orton is paying dearly for that.
Snapmare once more, Jimmy on the inside, up to the second turnbuckle. Big fist right between the eyes. Certainly didn't waste any time in getting this one going. Orton thought he was going to get a shot here and take advantage of the Superfly as he was taking his gear off. But boy, did he come back in a hurry.
Jimmy Snuka has tremendous resiliency. Tremendous resiliency, and he is everything that the people believe he is, a phenom.
Absolutely. Snuka now in, double shot right across. What a chop as down goes the Cowboy. Ace is not looking too well right now.
Ace had a fleeting moment at the beginning on his own accord, and it's all been Snuka thus far.
Fantastic upper body development on the part of the Fly. Look out, atomic drop inside. That'll stop whatever you're doing.
That could very easily shift the momentum in a hurry.
Orton now doesn't seem to be too the worse for wear as he's starting to methodically go to work on the Fly. Jimmy has to be more resilient than anyone I know, Howard, after coming back from that onslaught at the hands of Piper with that chair too long ago.
Not anyone can recover as quickly as Jimmy Snuka. The recuperative powers of Mr. Snuka were just phenomenal.
Well, I thought that was the end of his career that night.
Oh, when he was carried out? Absolutely. What a great return.
Jimmy with a headbutt. Jimmy off the ropes. Flying, no, over the top rope, both men.
Oh.
What a fantastic fall that was. Both men stunned as they both went over the top rope backwards. On the arena floor, and now Orton trying to get back in.
No.
Oh, there's the bell. Both men must have been counted out here.
How quick the tide turns.
Let's go back and take a look at that tremendous fall upside down as both men. Here comes Jimmy Superfly Snuka off the ropes. High cross body. Look at this. Upside down. You could break your neck or back there very easily. Back to live action as Orton brings the Fly back inside the ring. But this match is over.
Look out.
Thrown out of the ring by Orton.
Orton is a man possessed. He is not happy with anything right now.
He's got the Fly in a dangerous position. As
he's going for the superplex.
He's going to try. He's setting Snuka up in the corner for the superplex. Will he be able to do it?
No official. Referee Kroll is out senseless on the floor.
No one in the ring. Look at Jimmy gave him a headbutt. Orton is just stunned but standing there. I can't believe it.
Jimmy's coming too.
Another big headbutt by Jimmy.
He could be in position for something. The crowd says do it. And here it comes.
Superfly going up to the top turnbuckle. Orton laying in a pro position. No. He rolled out. He failed.
Goodbye.
Head first, and Dick Crow is still on the floor. And Jimmy wants this guy back into the ring. Saying, come on. Dick Kroll hurt and hurt seriously as he can hardly make it to his feet. And look at the look on the Fly's face.
It's going to be interesting to see the decision.
I'm sure both men were counted outside the ring, but just to be on the safe side, let's go up and get the official word.
Gentlemen, both wrestlers have been counted out of the ring. It is declared a double countout.
Double countout. Both men counted outside of the ring after that tremendous fall. You're watching the World Wrestling Federation on Madison Square Garden Network.
One fall with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first the manager, Luscious Johnny Valiant. And now now, ladies and gentlemen, the participants. To my right, hailing from Italy, weighing 237 pounds, Salvatore Dell'Omo. And his opponent, parts unknown, weighing 273 pounds, Brutus Beefcake.
Parts unknown, give me a break, Howard.
Where does he come off from parts unknown? I don't think he knows where he is anyway. Oh, that's the odd couple out there with Johnny Valiant.
This is going to be something happening right here because the Brutai, I call him, is obviously in great physical condition.
No doubt.
And unless Salvatore can use the scientific skills that he knows and the speed and agility that he has, he will fall prey to the Brutai.
You know, it's interesting about Brutus Beefcake. When he first entered the World Wrestling Federation, everyone was after him to sign a contract. Managerial offers came in from literally all over the world, and no one thought that luscious Johnny Valiant, a complete dark horse, a complete forgotten person, was going to secure the services of him. Out of the blue, he came
out of the woodwork.
Tremendous. Apparently, Johnny Valiant had the right chemistry and the right offer to lure Brutus Beefcake. Many wrestling people think that Brutus Beefcake, perhaps, has got a great future in professional wrestling. And with Johnny Valiant, who is no slouch in the ring as a wrestler and is a very talented tactician, you just don't know what's going to happen with these two.
I think it was a very clever maneuver on his part, Howard. Very, very clever maneuver on the part of the luscious one.
Look at that.
Put him right back in the swing of things. Put him right back in the limelight. Great acquisition.
And he really outfoxed some of the foxiest managers. What kind of a getup does Brutus Beefcake have on? Is it from outer space?
I don't know. It looks like some kind of a lightning bolt hit him or something.
My
goodness.
Just
shattered him into two different pieces.
Right out of
the when I was active in the ring, Howard, we never had any outfits like this. I didn't even know they existed. The luscious one now disrobing the Brutus. This match is underway. I'm sure the bell is rung. Let's get it going.
What do you think is going through the mind of Salvatore Bellomo right now?
Salvatore Bellomo. There's Mr. and Mrs. Bellomo, who just recently came here. In fact, I believe it was this week or possibly even tonight. They arrived from Italy to watch their son.
They just saw themselves on TV.
And welcome to them, and I hope you enjoy your stay here in America, and congratulations to your son.
What do you think Mr. and Mrs. Bellomo think of Brutus Beefcake?
Well, I'm sure they've never seen anything in Italy like Brutus Beefcake, but I'm sure they think very, very highly of their son, who has come here to America from Italy, made a name for himself in the world of professional wrestling, and most important of all, a name for himself here in the World Wrestling Federation.
For sure, Salvatore Bellomo. Bellomo has lived out his dream to try and get into the best. He's made it, and he still struggles all the time. Although right now, he's losing his patience. Brutus Beefcake. Seems that the managers in the World Wrestling Federation always try and outpsych the opponents through their talent.
Well, they should not be allowed at ringside. If I had to say so, they wouldn't be. They can come out with their individual and take ring instructions and then goodbye. Look at this. Whoa, what a slam by Brutus Beefcake as he drove Salvatore down into the canvas. Salvatore hurt by that slam, and rightly so, because it was almost a power slam.
There's another thing I question about Brutus Beefcake in the times I've seen him. Why do the World Wrestling Federation allow him to wear those forearm pads?
Well, those particular forearm pads, from my vantage point right here tonight, Howard, seem to be material. Sometimes he goes into that ring with ones that are not material, that are metal and plastic in nature, and that to me is strictly illegal and cannot be used.
I don't know how he's been able to get away with it thus far.
Well, that's why you have a guy like the luscious one in your corner.
For sure.
To make sure those things happen.
For sure. It's quite a unique individual, Brutus Beefcake.
Salvatore not faring too well at the moment, but don't count this guy out because he's got a world of experience behind him. Side headlock now by Brutai.
Where Brutus Beefcake might be a deliberate individual inside the ring, I think Salvatore Bellomo has one up on Beefcake with his vast knowledge of not only the catch-as-catch-can style, but the Greco-Roman style as well.
Oh, I'm sure that Salvatore has forgotten more wrestling than Bruce Beefcake will ever know, but whether he can get away with it remains to be seen. He caught him with a scoop slam, and Brutus is not too happy as he bails out.
It's time for a consultation.
Look
Johnny
at the luscious
Knight
one,
running,
hustling around. Oh, my God, what happened, my boy? Welcome to the World Wrestling Federation. What could he possibly be complaining about? His man got slammed off the ropes. Very well done and very well executed by a true professional in Salvatore Palomo.
Well, the referee's starting to count Beefcake out. He better listen to the count or else it's going to be too late.
Look into the eyes of the luscious one, and if he's playing with a full deck, I'm very surprised, Howard.
Definitely not.
Brutus now coming back inside. Took a little breather out there. I'm sure he got the wind knocked out of him on that slam. Salvatore very cautious. You got it when a guy's got this much power. Can't just tie up like anyone ordinarily would, because this guy'll just drive you into next week. Side headlock now by the Beefcake. Salvatore doesn't want to stay in this too long because this guy's upper body, there he goes, throws him off. Salvatore with a nice drop down over the top. Brutus hung on, and oh, he outsmarted himself as Palomo nails him with a drop kick.
There he
and
goes.
Sticks him right out over the top rope once again to the outside.
Johnny Valiant not too excited about the prospects that far.
I'm sure that the Palomos are happy right now about the happenings here in the Meadowlands Arena as they spend their first evening in America.
Well, the Palomos have to be impressed with the awe, the size of the crowd, the immense popularity, and probably the immense popularity that Salvatore Palomo has, although Brutus Beefcake has got the upper hand right now.
Starting to lower the heavy artillery. That's three big rights in a row as Salvatore is reeling, and another one by Brutus. Brutus saying, come on, get up, you're tough. Let's see how tough you are. Salvatore hard into the top turnbuckle as he's feeling the wrath now, as Brutus wasn't too happy about being drop-kicked out of the ring. Plants a foot right in the lower abdomen. That was not an illegal maneuver. Diane happy now. Luscious John, and once again, the relentless attack on the part of Brutus Beefcake at the hands and the insults being issued out now. And Salvatore Palomo, the recipient. Well, how much pounding can a man take of this nature from a guy with this kind of power? Look at that forearm, just drove him backward. Salvatore comes back with a boot and another one. Scoops the legs, that's one. Oh, look at this, let's stretch out the hamstrings. Yes, Salvatore reaches down inside. That's one of his favorite maneuvers.
And that has got to hurt.
Shall I make a wish? Make a wish for your folks, Sal. Go ahead. Do it. If it feels good, do it, Sal. He's wasting too much time here. He's going to let him have it again, and another shot as those ligaments and tendons are being stretched out on that. That'll make you walk kind of funny for a while. Valiant concerned now as he looks on. Palomo now with a whip. No, reversal. Nicely done. Backdrop, but no, a leapfrog by Palomo. Ducks the big right hand. Oh, there's that vicious knee right off the ropes. Goodbye. He's down and out.
How sudden the changes happen. All of a sudden, where Palomo and Beefcake were having a go-round back and forth, all of a sudden, bingo. Beefcake comes up with the knee, makes Johnny Valiant a happy man. Another win for Brutus Beefcake, and another notch up the ladder in the World Wrestling Federation.
Not a pleasing thing to see for the Palomos, but stay with us, wrestling fans. More exciting action coming up in a moment. Was a sensational one.
It was certainly beyond my wildest expectations, Gorilla. Mr. Wonderful Paul Orndorff certainly demonstrating that he is not a happy loser.
Well, certainly not, and my hat's off to JYD for showing everyone the kind of gumption that he's got and where he's coming from. And incidentally, the Superfly was just unbelievable. I'm so happy to see that he's back here and in full power and full command of all his physical attributes, as I thought at one point in time that Rowdy Roddy had literally terminated his career.
Oh, well, Jimmy Snuka proved beyond the shadow of a doubt that he is 150% back for good, perhaps, Gorilla, as Cowboy Bob Orton, I'm sure, will attest to.
I'm sure of that. And still, as this capacity crowd looks on here in the Meadowlands, still to come, the biggie. The big one, Big John Studd, who claims to be the true giant and the only giant, takes on the Hulkster. Well, Hulkamania, as you know, Howard, is running wild everywhere.
The way this card has been this evening, Ted Lewis used to say, you ain't seen nothing yet. And when we get this World Wrestling Federation heavyweight matchup between Big John Studd and Hulk Hogan, East Rutherford, the Meadowlands, the entire metro area is going to rock and roll. There's no doubt about it.
It is unbelievable the amount of excitement and electricity that can be produced by one individual, and that is the Hulkster. And believe me, I don't know of another individual that comes to mind immediately who can create that kind of response.
I must give credit again. It seems that I'm a Bobby Heenan partisan. Believe me, I'm not. But the man is brained again. He's masterminded. Big John Studd, who is now coming down the aisle with his manager into a title opportunity. Hulk and Studd are no strangers to one another. They have had their go rounds. John Studd claims he's never been defeated. He's never been slammed. Gorilla, that $15,000 body slam challenge, I believe, is on the line tonight. $15,000 if Big John Studd is slammed by Hulk Hogan. You never know. The title, the body slam challenge, it is going to be unreal.
The $15,000 is always up for grabs.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. It is set for one fall with a 1 hour time limit. It is for the World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first the manager, Bobby the Brain Heenan. And ladies and gentlemen, the challenger from Los Angeles, California, weighing 364 pounds, Big John.
Mr. Giant John Studd.
Studd. And his opponent,
the people, the enthusiasm for the World Wrestling Federation champion. He's not happy with it for sure. This is deafening, Gorilla.
Hulkster showing everybody he's going to slam the big guy.
This place turns automatically electric.
Unbelievable, you could cut it with a knife. Title on the line. Golden opportunity for Big John Studd.
Gorilla behind the Hulkster 1,000%.
Nobody's sitting down yet.
No, sir. Big John Studd is like a man without a country right now. Bobby Heenan can't believe it. John Studd is ready.
Bell is rung. We're underway.
We're going to try and corner Bobby Heenan here for just a moment and find out if that challenge is on the line. Bobby, we want to just verify with you. This is another tug for Big John Studd for the World Wrestling Federation title. We want to verify with you, is the $15,000 body slam challenge valid in this match?
It's always valid. And like I said, it's $15,000 to any wrestler that can slam John Studd in the ring. And so far, pal, that money's still drawing interest. And it's going to continue to do that.
swear anyone that I know of at any given time, including Big John Studd, if the circumstances are right.
Studd is impressive, though. Let's not shortcut him at all.
It's the immovable object in there against the irresistible force.
Truly a battle of the Titans.
Something's going to happen.
Listen to the crowd. My goodness.
Look at the Hulkster. Is he in shape? Studd saying, come on, go for it if you think you can do it. Look at the look of determination. Hulk obviously in fantastic condition. Tie up like two big bull mooses. And Studd trying to slam him. And the Hulk trying to slam Big John. Now reversed again. He got a part way up.
He can't touch him.
Tough when a guy's just standing there to do that. You got to have things going. You got to have momentum going. You got to have everything going for you.
Uh-oh.
He didn't say take it easy, and he almost got kicked right in the kisser by the Hulkster. Heenan saying he's not bothering anybody, but he certainly is bothering.
Bobby Heenan can play a very integral part in this match from a distraction standpoint. He certainly can make life miserable for Hulk Hogan if the opportunity arises, Gorilla.
Studd now, I certainly agree to that, Howard. Studd in control as he, wow, look at that shoulder block and nothing happened. Hulkster came off the ropes hard, ran right into the big guy with a shoulder block. Studd now going for a slam again. No, there's the Hulk, look, he got him up. Oh my God, was that close. Hulkster had him part way up there, and he wasn't anywhere near the ropes. Misses a big elbow. Wow, Hulkster plants one on him. Two big lefts, three, four. Wow, big right hand. Hulkster now sends Big John into the ropes. Boot right in the side of the face. He is stunned. He doesn't know where he is. Now's the time to slam him. Wow, just couldn't get underneath him that far to get him up that time. As John stops him, forces the champion back into the corner. Oh, what a forearm. That'll knock your chest about 3 inches back, closer to your heart. And another one.
Bobby Heenan is no dummy, Gorilla. He knows that a victory will bring him something that he's wanted for a long, long time.
Well, that's what it's all about, the gold, the title. John Studd now trying to shove the champion into the corner, but blocked it by using the ropes, and now unleashes a relentless shot of right hands and throws a big guy into the ropes. Look out. Close lined him right in a kisser.
Studd is not down yet. He still has
Well, power. He might as well be because he doesn't know where he is. Look out. Got him up. All he's got to do is turn him over. He couldn't do it. Close, 15 grand.
That looked like
the 75.
That looked like $7,500, almost halfway.
Holy mackerel! He had him up there. Actually, all he had to do was turn him. But easier said than done, believe me, folks. Shouting instructions from the corner, Bobby the Brain, as he tells his man to use the heavy artillery on the champion. Hulkster now, wheeled across, no, reversal as Big John goes in, and Hulk follows him right in with a big clothesline right hand. The Cannon scoops him up again. He's got him up now. He reached the top rope.
Let me interject something, if I may. Hulk Hogan better not be too preoccupied with trying to slam John Studd because, as I said, it could be trouble for him.
Being dragged out now, both men on the floor, right in front of us here, as Studd rams the Hulkster's head into our table. Everything is in jeopardy here. Both men outside on the Meadowlands Arena floor. Hulk in trouble, and he gets smashed right into the steel post. In jeopardy here of being counted outside the ring. Big John made it back in. Now Dick Worley will have to get him back to continue the count on the Hulkster, who is already he's busted open.
The Hulkster is
smashed into the steel post. Blood oozing down, the face down, but certainly not out. Look at the Hulkster. He's going to be throwing bananas.
So right now, things are not looking too good for Hulk Hogan.
He's cut and cut severely.
And John Studd knows it.
Studd once again out after the champion.
Oh, no.
Oh, rams him into the steel guardrail. as if the post wasn't bad enough. And fans urging on the Hulkster, champion in a lot of trouble. Hulk trying to get back towards the ring. John Studd already back in there. Stops the count on the outside. He wants this guy back in the ring because that's the only way he can get the title. And the chant goes up Hogan as the champ bleeds profusely from the face area. Don't count this guy out by a long shot. Look at the Hulk. Trying desperately to get back to his feet. Trying every which way he can, pulling on everything to get back into that ring. No way he wants to be counted out. And no way John Studd wants him to be counted out either, Howard. Can't win the title that way.
He's got to bring him in the ring and get that three count, Gorilla. He knows what a count out is.
Turns him around once more and lashes another big shot right across the already busted open area on the face, maybe above the eye of the Hulkster. Tough ones, that blood starts running into your eyes. You can't really see what's going on, as is evident here. Hulk snatches the leg of the big giant. Pulls him outside, but no, with the other foot, Big John Studd able to push off the champ. And now just throws him back into the ring. He's got the one thought in mind, get that title. Big John Studd going up to the top rope. Can he get up there? Yes.
Never seen John Studd this way.
Look at this. Here he comes right on the back of the neck of the champion. This could be the beginning of the end of the title for Hogan.
Bobby Heenan saying finish him off. Bobby Heenan sensing a victory. And John Studd is going to try and accommodate him.
John Studd throws the champion. Oh. Big elbow right to the forehead. Down for the cover. This we could have a new champion here. No. Two and a half, he could not hold his shoulder down. Hulkster just reaching down for something inside, maybe even an involuntary motion, just forced his way out of that. Holy mackerel, I can't believe it. Look at the blood all over the tights of Big John Studd. It all belongs to the champion. Once again, thrown in for that big elbow. Yes, clothesline him across the throat. Down for the cover once more. This could be it. Now, no.
Two and a half.
Just got that right arm stuck into the
side. Look at Bobby Heenan. Bobby Heenan looks like his whole world is almost at a pinnacle, and then it comes down.
Studd's saying he's going to slam him. He's going to pick him up and slam him and then cover him and maybe get that title. Never seen the champ in as much trouble as he's in right now since almost a year ago he captured the title. There he goes. He got him up for the slam. 300 pounds plus. Wow, did he hit hard. Fortunately for the Hulkster, he's close to those ropes. Heenan screaming, finish him, finish him. I can't believe Studd is giving the Hulk this opportunity. Big boot as out goes the champion once again. Boy, he spent a lot of time on this arena floor. That's not the place to be.
John Studd certainly, as you mentioned, giving Hulk Hogan every opportunity to try and come back. He could have finished him off at any time he wanted to.
Well, he tried to finish him off twice, and twice the Hulkster reached out for something deep inside, as only a man with championship caliber material can do. Hulkster now once again pulling the big guy outside the ring to get a breather, but Big John Studd following the champ around the ring, still administering those heavy shots, punishing blows to the back and neck area of the champion. Uh-oh. The Hulk is starting to pull that neck. We've seen him do that before. Where he gets it, I don't know, but look at that look. He blocks it. A big right hand. He's got it.
He
slams
it.
It wasn't in the ring, though.
No.
He slammed the big guy on the floor. He slammed him. He won't get the money. Has to be inside the ring. Let's see. The bell has sounded. Maybe both men were counted out here. I really don't know.
Very cloudy right now.
John Studd down and hurt. Obviously, Hulk would get the belt back, but whether he's won the match, I don't know.
I think we have the decision, Gorilla.
Let's get it.
Ladies and gentlemen, Big John Studd counted out of the ring, the winner and still World Wrestling Federation Heavyweight Champion, the Incredible Hulk Hogan.
Hulkster on to victory. There goes the music. The Eye of the Tiger is still down on the arena floor. Is the challenger Big John Studd. Let's go back in time just a few moments. Well, let's stay with this because look, the Hulk is giving us a shot. Well, there he is outside on the floor. Here comes the slam right now.
And with the force,
he drove him right back down in there. Let's go back up to the ring. With this capacity crowd in his pocket as he's got everybody on their feet. Pandemonium at the Meadowlands.
Hulkamania has run wild again, Gorilla.
Boy, he accomplished a number of things in slamming a big guy. Unfortunately, will not get the money. And believe it or not, folks, just now, trying to get back to his feet is Big John Studd.
Bobby Heenan has got to be one upset individual.
Well, I'm sure that Big John Studd is extremely upset and hurt right now as he was slammed on this ice floor here in the Meadowlands Arena, much to his dismay and chagrin, as the champion showed him what a powerhouse he is. Unfortunately, he doesn't get the $15,000 because it was not inside the squared circle. Bobby Heenan very concerned. Big John Studd, lower back, kidney area, obviously hurt. Fantastic night of wrestling, as only the World Wrestling Federation can bring you, right here at the jam-packed Meadowlands Arena. And Howard, my good friend Howard Finkel, I want to thank you very much.
I've had a pleasure with you here, Gorilla. I hope to do it again sometime. We've seen a great night of wrestling, as only the World Wrestling Federation can provide.
Please be my guest at any time. Well, that wraps it up for tonight's World Wrestling Federation action. Federation has been brought to you by